Hi, welcome to our sports special edition. We're here at the Alamo Dome in San Antonio, Texas.
At the Dallas Cowboy training camp.
And you're watching The Spot. Hi, and welcome back to The Spot. We're here at the Dallas Cowboy training camp. And today, we're gonna be taking a look inside the Javelinas, the Mighty Brahmas, and none other than the Dallas Cowboys. So that's a lot to handle. So now, we're gonna go to Melissa, where she's gonna take a look inside the Mighty Brahmas.
Thanks, Vicky, and welcome back to Kingsville. To my right here, I have special Brahma correspondent, Elizabeth Rodriguez.
Today we're going to take an inside look and a preview of the Brahma football team.
These Brahmas face some key changes and new roles. The question coming into this year is, will the Brahmas be back in the playoffs? It won't be easy with the return of GP and Rockport Fulton. However, Kingsville's team speed may vault the Brahmas back into postseason play.
I think it'll come down to speed. We don't have as size as last year, but our speed should make up for it.
We have improved different areas of our game. I think quickness-wise and speed-wise, we're better off than we have been before. Size-wise, this year, we're not as big as we were. So we're a different football team. I think offensively, we have the ability to move the ball around more this year. I think defensively, we run the ball better this year. So I think there are some aspects of our game that are improved.
Our defense, we lost a couple of people, a couple of starters. But this year, our speed, our average speed has it's gotten better.
This team's success may rely on the shoulders of incoming quarterback Gali Aguilad. What are your team's expectations for this season?
This season, we're just out to have a good year. Our defense is coming along. Our offense is still working. Since I'm new, I'm getting used to it. So you gotta learn a lot of stuff by reading, the offense he runs, which is the option. So it's kind of hard, but I'll get there. Well, football, throwing the football is different from throwing the baseball. Everything's over the top. But from working over the summer and stuff, I think I got it down pretty good. Whenever we played our first scrimmage against Bevo, we didn't have much enthusiasm, and that's how we got beat. But this past week, whenever we played them on Thursday, we were pumped up, and that's what happened. We beat them.
Now let's check in with Brahma reporter Arlena Four.
These Brahmas are coming off their first playoff appearance since 1997, but the revamped district will bring tough competition in 2002.
Our district, it's going to be a little bit tougher, but same expectations. We're just going to have to play with all our heart, emotion, and everything. Just going to have to lay it all on the field.
Well, I'll tell you, these are not new teams to us. We play them every year, and they're certainly good football teams. We have five playoff teams coming back into the district this year, and I think the positive thing about it is, back when this was an 18 district, we had a semifinal representative 8 years in a row. And what it leads you to believe is, if you can get out of this district and get into the playoffs, you certainly have a chance to make a good run in the playoffs. So, we feel good about our chances. I think there's probably eight teams in this district that's got a good chance to make the playoffs. So it's going to be a tough road, but we feel good about our chances.
These Wild and Woolly Bulls are looking to be the surprise of this year's 34A district race. Don't miss it.
Make sure you stay tuned, because when we come back, our football special continues with an inside look at Javelina football.
Back to The Spot. Today we're joined by former Kingsville Record reporter Daisy Sosa. Daisy, we're here at Javelina Football Stadium, the home, of course, of the A&M Kingsville Javelinas, and the site of so many major college football victories.
Well, for the 2002 season, the Javelinas have the same goal as they do every year, to win a national championship. I hope as bad as I want to win. That's what we try to instill in them. We try to tell them how important it is, the tradition of this place. Let them not be the bunch that breaks the tradition. So it's we try to make it very important to them.
Well, it's a lot of, to me, personal is pressure, you know, coming out and performing like those guys did in the past. You know, just keep the tradition alive. That's basically what everyone's out here to do. We just come out and we know what's expected from us, from the community. You know, and it's all up to us to come out and, you know, perform to the expectations that everyone has of us.
The community, and certainly themselves, the Javelinas expect no less than to win.
Now we go one team at a time. We're not really concerned about anybody. I personally feel like we'll run through our conference.
We have a lot of good talent. We have speed. We have not only speed, we have people that want to win championships. You know what I'm saying? So, gotta get it.
And the formula? Well, there aren't many secrets when you're the all-time winningest program in Division II football history.
That's it. We'll always be aggressive and controlling the football, taking care of the football, trying to score points, and trying to occupy as much of the clock as you can.
I mean, we're a bunch of soldiers. Everybody out here is soldiers. We kind of like to keep it gutter. Keep it gutter around here. That's what we say. We keep it gutter. With my boy Wig, Mike Clay, Tracy James, Cody Eatman, Terrence Mouton. Just everybody just got a blue collar attitude. Go to work.
Everybody knows what it takes to, you know, to go to the big game. So I guess, you know, we're on track. You know.
Your prediction. How do you think you're gonna do?
I'm just going to play hard and try to get a W.
Walter Wigfall, a.k.a. Big Wig, position offensive tackle, senior. Yeah, we've been out here working hard, banging, you know, we grinding. We out here grinding it out, working hard like we on the block or something. We fit to do this. Yeah, man, I know we're going to win a conference. Hopefully we're going to go get this national championship. We got a lot of talent that we can go gel together. We're going to do that damn thing. Leave a message. Nah, there ain't no weakness we have, you know. All we got to do is practice hard, play hard, and we're going to do the damn thing. Leave a message. Yeah, man, we take a lot of pride in our old line, man. We go out there, we run up and down the field. We hit, we cherry pick, you know, we ball hard. We love this, yeah. We love hitting people. That's why we play that old line. Leave a message. Nah, I don't worry about nothing. Big Wig, baby. It's me. You know, I balls. That's what I do. Leave a message. Oh, yeah, Coach Cutter, that's my partner. I've been here 4 years with him. He cool, dude. He just mellowed out since I first got here. He was a little wild like me when I first got here, a little crazy, tell you what he'll do to you. You know, I love that man. He cool. Leave a message. I don't even think about it, man. If it happened, you know it happened. If it don't, you know I hang out with Clay somewhere.
Hello, I'm not at home. Leave a message.
Play real aggressive and just try to knock people out. The more you eliminate, the less you have to play against.
Well, thanks a lot for tuning in. Be sure to tune in next week to see the spot.
Wait a minute. What do you mean? Did y'all want to see something about the Dallas Cowboys?
The Dallas Cowboys? That's right, I almost forgot. Roll it!
The Dallas Cowboys enter the 2002 football campaign with much fanfare but little proven. Relying on a host of newcomers and young talent on both sides of the ball, the spot previews the Dallas Cowboys.
Well, I would say we're better. That's something, you know, we're going to have to find out during the season. You know, we've kind of taken the theme that we're building a house here, and we feel like we've got the ingredients and we've built the walls and the roof, and now we've got to furnish the place, and that's what happens during the season.
Defensively, the Cowboys should be even better with the additions of All-Pro linebacker Kevin Hardy, number one pick Roy Williams, and All-Pro defensive tackle Leroy Glover.
Defensively, we're really deep. As Zim said, our defense coordinator said, a lot of good football players won't make this football team because it's a numbers game. That means, you know, we should have an excellent group of guys this year.
I feel really good. It's good to feel good. It's frustrating when you hurt, when you come off an injury, and you know people expect you to be 100%, but you're really not 100% yet. So it's good. Thank God that I am healthy this year. It was healthy last year. So I just pray my health continues.
The Cowboys suffered a stunning loss in the season opener to the expansion Houston Texans. However, these Cowboys know it's a long season, and the pieces are there to put Dallas back on top of the NFL.
You know, I just think that we still have a very good chance because our defense is fairly solid. Offensively, we're going to be okay. We got guys coming back, offensive linemen that are coming back and getting back healthy. And I really still feel very good about where we are and where we're headed. And, you know, in the NFL, every week is a challenge. And I think this team will be up to every challenge.
Dallas press and other parts of the media around the nation feel like this is your last year as a Dallas Cowboy. What's that all about?
I have no idea. I guess they're just trying to look at situations in terms of salary cap, in terms of age, and claiming that this could be it. But, you know, they really don't know. They really don't know. They're just making an assumption. A lot of cases, it could be obvious for other people, but what's really obvious for other people is not necessarily what's happening with me. But at the same time, you know, I'm not even going to concern myself with those things. And a lot of times, the press don't have nothing to talk about. So they create a story. Or they create a different angle to so they can have something that's out there that's lingering. And everybody want to be the one to say, I told you so. So that's how it works. And, you know, hey, that's the nature of the game.
Last year, improving was the theme for rookie quarterback Quincy Carter. And this year, it's really no different.
Well, you know, when I first came here, everything overwhelmed me. I mean, everybody looked bigger and faster and stronger. But, you know, as I started to look on the sidelines, I started to see the same guys about my size. And, you know, everybody's got the same ability. And God has given me a lot of innate ability. So only thing I need to do is just go out and use the ability that God has given me and get better every time I step out on the field. I don't even worry about, you know, competition. I worry about competing with myself because I want to be the best quarterback to ever play this game.
Optimism is high coming out of Dallas. However, let's check in with our self-proclaimed armchair quarterbacks to get those hard-hitting football questions.
How are you doing today?
Just fine, with you standing next to me.
Well, my day just got better, too. How's camp treating you?
It's good. I think this is about the latter part of camp here where everybody's a little bit tired, and you can tell the rust is starting to get to us a little bit. But, you know, I think we're having a great time out here in San Antonio, and I think these fans have been great these last 3 or 4 weeks.
So how important are the fans to you to be out here supporting you?
They're very important at this time, at this point in time in camp, simply because everybody's so tired, and you can just feel that the excitement that we had at the first part of camp is not there anymore. So getting these fans out here is great to, you know, get us excited during the practices now.
Hi, how are you doing today?
Oh, I'm beat. I got camp legs.
Oh, I bet you are. You know, I was wondering, y'all wake up so early for this. Like, what gets you up in the morning? How do you wake up? I mean, it was so hard for us to get out here.
You know, we have the opportunity as professionals to do stuff that 99% of the people out there can't do. So, you know, every day you need to wake up and just, you know, embrace the moment and be excited to come out here and do what we love in front of, you know, fanatical fans and just be excited about it.
Okay, there's no question to who I am talking to right now. I am talking to the Emmitt Smith. How are you today?
I am fine.
Knowing that practice is going to end, how are you going to celebrate?
Well, I may celebrate a little bit by going out tonight and maybe take the guys out for dinner and relax a little bit and enjoy probably one of our last off nights here in San Antonio.
How do you relax? What do you do?
Well, I don't know what we're going to do today. We may go shoot a little pool, maybe go have a few martinis or something like that, smoke a cigar or two, just something just to change the pace of training camp.
People want to know, what is your favorite color, Emmitt?
My favorite color is blue.
Blue, mine too.
Really?
Awesome. All right. So we have something in common right now.
Right, right.
All right, cool. So how has camp been treating you?
Very, very rough. It's hard, but it's fun. It's fair. You just come out here and try to get ready to play a long season. Team unity is all you really got in football. You know, you see some individuals making plays out there, but nobody steps up and make a play without the next person doing something to help them out. So football is the ultimate team sport. I really believe that.
Regardless of how Dallas does this year, it appears to be a milestone season as Emmitt Smith closes in on Walter Payton's all-time rushing record. And don't think for a second it's something he hasn't considered.
I can't even really describe in words really what it really gonna mean to me. And you know, it's kind of exciting and get kind of emotional just thinking about the opportunity that lays before me. So I look forward to having the opportunity to do so. Don't know when it's gonna happen, but we continue to do some of the things we've been doing in practice and improving on a daily basis. It can happen sometime this year. So emotionally, it's gonna probably be a very emotional moment and an exciting moment.